Yo, Space Server Natural. Today we have Rebel Moon Part 2, the Scaregiver trailer. Let's just get into this.
Their nightmare is you and I fighting together.
You must know.
All right.
You cannot win.
You're all here. Because there is nothing to return to.
That sounds like audio slave in the background.
Dark days
what the frick?
Lie ahead of us all. We will teach you how to fight.
Okay.
That's impressive.
They
the Stargate is among them.
David,
what was this
audio slave remix going in the background?
I shall destroy them.
Holy crap. Have our evil general guy coming back.
I have no choice but to fight.
Yourself. Take it on me. April 19th.
The Scargiver herself.
Go, 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 go!
Are you truly prepared to allow this to continue in your name?
I'm sorry. I won't allow this place to die for me.
Okay.
God, it's hanging out
there. Okay. That's a really weird music choice. But you have me wanting to see the movie based off the music alone, so you have to be doing something right. Okay, so first Rebel Moon. On the day I'm recording this, I just released a review. I was really excited for the first movie, and it didn't land. The trailer looked really cool. It seemed really cool. Zack Snyder's take on Star Wars, and it just ended up being all the ingredients to make A New Hope, but just bland. And this seems like we're going, like, the battle, which I'm down for just, like, the battle of a movie. Like, just battle it. Like, war movie. That sounds awesome. And you use Cochise by Audioslave. That's used in, like, the Iron Man trailer. And Iron Man's much better than Rebel Moon. So, that actually looks kind of cool. I'm interested to see what happens. Hopefully we get more of that robot guy and more of the stuff at the beginning of Rebel Moon that kind of made it feel interesting. Hopefully they do more of the interesting lore stuff, and since this isn't a recruitment movie, I feel like this could be better. And I don't know how you couldn't be better than Child of Fire, because that was not a very good movie. So if this is even a good movie, I'm gonna be happy, because Rebel Moon Child of Fire wasn't a very good movie. But if Part 2 of The Scaregiver is just a fun sci-fi action movie, then I think we're in for a treat. And yeah, that's all I have to say about it. Looks cool, but the first one looked cool. So I'm gonna hope it looks cool, but I also know the first one looked cool and was kinda eh. So as long as this one looks cool and is cool, then we're good. So hopefully that's the case, and with all that being said, Space Cypher out. Peace!